So let's talk black and white macro photography. Why would you even consider such an idea? In my case, it was lack of inspiration. I felt a deep lack of photography inspiration for maybe 1 or 2 months. And that really sucks. I mean, I'm into photography because I love the excitement and passion I feel for going out and taking photos. And when you haven't felt that for a while, you kind of lose interest. But I have some tricks up my sleeve, and the best trick I've found is to actually enforce some kind of restriction on yourself. And a good restriction, I think, if, for example, if you, like me, love colors and bringing out colors in whatever you're shooting, try shooting black and white. Try forcing yourself for one photo walk to only shoot black and white and see what happens. I have found that when you put some restrictions on your creativity, you actually become more creative and you enjoy it more because you discover new ways to do photography. And that was the case today as well, when I went out and decided to only shoot black and white. It didn't matter that much that there aren't any flowers or insects outside. When I force myself to shoot black and white, I find new angles, find new subjects, I find new ways to do my photography. And it was actually a lot of fun. For example, this tree with fungus on it, I don't think I would have found it very beautiful in colors, but in black and white, it has something to it. I played around with the composition, trying to find the right angle, and in the end I settled on this composition, where the lines on the tree and the fungus aligns with the frame. Normally when I'm shooting trees, I try to do vertical orientation, but in this case, I found this orientation nicer. Since I'm not using a flash today, and since it was pretty dark, it's Swedish winter, I cranked the ISO up to 400 so that I always have enough shutter speed to take my photos. And ISO 400 is normally something I would refrain from, but in black and white, a little bit of grain can actually even make the photos look nicer, I think. I think grain goes really well together with black and white. And contrast. You can get so nice compositions with silhouettes against a bright background in black and white. For some reason it becomes much easier, because when you remove all the colors, you only have shades of gray and black and white, and you can much easier make a minimalistic composition. And with a blurred out background, it's easier to find the contrast, because you don't have to match the colors to contrast with each other. You only have the gray tones and black and white. So in many ways it's actually simpler, I think, to shoot in black and white, while it is of course also harder because you're so used to leveraging colors in everything you do, so you find yourself a bit disoriented. When going out for a photo walk like this, the best tip I can give you, and this applies no matter if it's black and white or not, is to take the first photo immediately, as soon as you can, even if you don't have anything nice to photograph. Because that will kick your brain into photography mode, and you will get so many more nice photos during the walk if you take the first photo as early as possible. Another good thing to try, which I did on this scene here, is to shoot everything from two angles if the sun is coming from one side. So first shoot, in this case the rosy pear, from where the sun is in the background, and then go to the other side and shoot it with the sun in your back. And usually one of these angles will look a lot better than the other one, especially in black and white. So that is what you have to try to find the best composition of your subject. These dried out rose hips don't look very good in color, but in black and white it is kind of interesting. And also with the background that is kind of slightly blurred out, I think it actually looks pretty nice. So now it's time for a short sponsor message before we return to the forest. This video is sponsored by Skillshare. And Skillshare is an online learning community where you can learn basically anything
but I am of course mostly interested in photography, so that is where I spend my time on Skillshare. I recently took Brandon Wolfel's course on portrait photography. If you don't know about him, he's one of the like most known photographers on Instagram and takes beautiful, beautiful, dreamy portraits. And it's so nice to get to follow his whole behind the scenes, from his philosophy and thinking to how he uses white balance and how he plans a shoot and how he follows the light to get to the best location for the shoot. So incredibly rewarding and interesting to learn these things from a master. And there are of course masters within other genres of photography like nature, wildlife, product photography, food photography, landscape, anything you can think of. So let's make 2020 the year where we take the next step in our creativity and in our skills in photography. And I'm not only saying this because Skillshare is the sponsor of this video, I truly mean that Skillshare is the best place online that you can do this. So it's less than $10 a month if you sign up for a year, and that is incredibly cheap. But if you use the link in the description of this video, you actually get 2 months of premium membership free of charge. So there is no risk at all. Go try it. You will love it. I promise you. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring. And now back to the forest.
So it was such a nice feeling to finally get the inspiration back and to finally feel the joy of photography again. Walking around with a camera, trying to capture nice compositions. This is what photography is all about for me. The enjoyment and meditative feeling of walking around taking photos. This is actually one of my favorites from this walk. Very simple and minimalistic, but still nice. One thing that is good to do if you have a mirrorless camera like I have is to set in the menu so that you have the black and white profile. So then that way when you're doing your compositions, you already see everything in black and white in your viewfinder, so you will see what the final photo looks like. This could of course be regarded as cheating by some DSLR users or rangefinder users, but I find it becomes even more fun when you actually see what the final image will look like in your viewfinder. So why not use the power of a mirrorless camera and leverage what it is good at? So as I mentioned earlier, one of the best ways to kickstart your creativity and inspiration is to limit yourself. And black and white is one way to limit yourself, but there are of course other things you could do. One suggestion would be that you stay within an area of maybe 20 by 20 feet or 8 by 8 meters or something, and you don't allow yourself to go outside this area for 1 hour, and you only take photos within this area. This is a great challenge because you will have to force yourself to be more creative and to find ways to take photos that you normally wouldn't find, because normally wouldn't force yourself to stay within a small area and shoot. So this is just one more suggestion to try. I might actually try it in a future YouTube video. Another thing you could try would be to use a completely different lens than what you're normally using. So if you have a favorite lens and it is say 100mm, why not try some wide angle photography? And if you're mostly shooting wide angle, why not try a telephoto lens? Forcing yourself to use a different tool or a different method of photography than what you're used to is a great way to regain inspiration. And here you have it, my favorite photo from this walk. Beautifully abstract and hard even to see what it is, but I love the background bokeh, I love the details in the small elements that are in focus. I simply love this photo. And here's another one I like, and if you look closely you can see that it was slightly out of focus. And I actually like the out of focus version more than the sharp one. This one has more feeling to it, I think. And it's always important when you review your photos to go on the gut feeling that you feel when you look at it, and not by how sharp the pixels are when you zoom in. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this video. I hope I inspired you a bit to try something new if you lose inspiration. Please do check out my inspiration newsletter as well. You can sign up for free at mwroll.com. It comes out once a month and it has my best tips and inspiration and tips about photographers and Instagram accounts and yeah. And speaking of Instagram accounts, please check out my photography over at mwroll on Instagram. I shoot mostly in color, as you can see. And last but not least, please do subscribe to this channel if you like macro photography. I make new videos every week. That's it. Thank you for watching. Over and out. Bye.